Hello everybody, this is Colin Goble. This tutorial is in several parts and it's intended to explore some of the finer aspects of using functions in C++. The first topic that I'd like to discuss is the topic of a scope of a variable. And we'll start by looking at this program called, well the program is called scope. I have here a function. The function has a name of doit. As you can see, it's a parameterless function. It returns nothing. And the sole thing it does, the only thing it does, is set the value of a variable called x to 20. Now my main program has a variable called x. It's declared there. It's set equal to 10. The value of x before the call to doit is displayed. Then we call doit, and then we output the value of x after the call to doit. And the question is, does the call to doit change the value of this variable x from 10 to 20? Well, let's run the program and find out. We run the program, we see that x before the call to doit is 10, and after the call to doit is still 10. Let's analyze why. The first declaration is of a variable x here. The name of the variable is x. The type of the variable is int. And the scope of the variable is the point of declaration to the innermost enclosing block, or in this case, the next closing curly brace. So the scope of this variable x is from the point of declaration, which is here, to the end of the enclosing block, or the enclosing curly brace, which is right there. And so the variable x is known, it's in scope, it's a valid variable name in the part of the program that's highlighted in blue. Notice that later in the function doit, there's another declaration of x. This is another variable. It happens to have the same name, just as there might be two Colin Gobles in this world, one of which teaches at PCC, and the other of which perhaps is a firefighter in Chicago. I don't know. There are two different objects that happen to have the same name. In this case, we see that there are two different variables. This one, which is called x and is of type int, which, by the way, is set to 20, but this variable called x is quite different from this variable called x, and the reference to x in the output statements, this x here, the reference is to the variable which is in scope. X here refers to this x and not this x. So in summary, we see that a declaration causes a variable to be declared, and the scope of that variable, the section of the program in which the name of that program, the name of that variable is valid, is the point of declaration to the end of the block in which it's declared. There's one x, there's another quite separate x. Now, if we were to remove this declaration, if I were to comment it out, and I compile the project now, you'll notice that in fact we get an error message. It says x undeclared, first use in this function. And that's because although a variable called x has been declared up here in main, that declaration is not valid. It's not in scope in the function called doit. So in this case, we get the error message x equals 20 tells us that x is undeclared. Now, if for some reason I want the same variable x, I want the x that's in main to be the same thing as the variable x that's in doit, the only way I can do that is to move the declaration of x outside both main and doit. And I can do that by writing the declaration here. I'll take out those comments. Now I have a declaration of x which is outside the definition of main and outside the definition of doit. In this case, x is said to be declared at file scope. The scope of x in this case is the point of declaration for the remainder of the entire source file. So the scope of x in this case includes both main and doit. So to repeat, variables declared here are said to be declared at file scope. Some people call them global variables, but the technical word for that is file scope. Okay, now if I do that, of course, I need to remove this declaration. And I need to remove this declaration. And now if I compile the program, both x's are the same, and so now before the call to do it, x is 20, but after the call to do it, x, excuse me, before the call to do it, x is 10, and after the call to do it, x is 20. Now, one more subtlety is that if you forget to, if you leave the declarations of x in here and x in here, the program still compiles okay. But we go back to the behavior of 10 and 10. And the reason for that is if I is within the function main, this x here refers to the declaration that has the innermost scope. So x here refers to this x that's declared in function scope, the x that's declared within in this block that defines the function main. This x is declared by that declaration there, so this x refers to that one. And in point of fact, this declaration and that declaration are said to shadow this declaration in this subtle situation. Although I have a variable x at file scope, that declaration in this case is overridden in the case of the function main by this declaration, which has that scope, and in the case of the function do it by this declaration, which has that scope. Well, that's a subtle and complicated issue, but I thought I'd mention it at the end of this tutorial. Thank you.